Hey guys, welcome back to Stoneheart with me, Banto. So, we're continuing this and we're getting invaded by goblins again. Wow, these are pretty many goblins coming this time. Six goblins? Whoa, that's pretty many and we're pretty low on this. And I did a stream on this game about 2 days ago and a guy told me that the more houses you get, the more people want to join your town, and I mean it does sound pretty logical, so I'm gonna trust on that and we're gonna try to build like more houses and see if we're gonna get more people. But for the moment we just need to defend ourselves against these invading goblins, and we're soon gonna get some more of those workers outfit, and there are some pretty good things coming to this game very soon with the future updates. I think that if you were a Kickstarter backer, you can already get some of those updates through the Stoneheart page, where you can download like the latest versions, which you don't seem to be able to do through like Humble Bundle. So I got my game from stoneheart.net, and then you got the link to like Humble, and you got your game there, your Steam key. And don't seem like we maybe have the same latest versions, but I'm actually currently running the one from Humble Bundle instead of downloading it from Steam. It kind of feels like it is more, a little bit more stable, maybe a little bit higher frames per second compared to the one on Steam. I don't know why. For me, it's like the same with Banish, that game. It's about the same thing with me. If I run it through Steam, I got like low frame rate, and so some softwares actually have problems with recording it, like making it crash. I think it was DxTor which has problem with it. Bandicam does not have much problems with any game at all, and that's the one that I use. So now you know that if you want to get a really good recorder for recording gameplay. So, but enough with that, we're gonna see if we have any more fences. Nope, no more fences. I'm gonna go through my crafting a little bit to see if there are anything we want to change here. So we're maintaining one, two doors, and it does seem pretty good what I'm trying to maintain here. And also inside here I made sure that I have this on the highest priority to upgrade the workers' outfit. So we're always gonna try to keep 3 of them ready. And we're also gonna try to keep 10 threads and 6 cloves, and you need 3 cloves to make 1 workers' outfit. Or actually it's just 2 cloves. What was it that required 3? Is it... Well, maybe it is that one of those require... Yeah. The bolt of cloves requires 3 threads. Okay. And also changes, so this stockpile here is not going to contain any food at all. So every food is going to move inside this building here. I think it does look a lot better, and in one way I think it is a little bit better for the defense against the goblins as well. Because we will know that like all the goblins are going to try to go inside this house. So we're basically making everybody move there. And let's see what the trader wants. Hello Lom, I'm just passing through, but even I can see that you have a skill crafting ranks. If you can make me 5 wooden doors, I'll be back in 1 day and might be able to give you 4 curtains in exchange. Sounds good. 5 wooden doors, we're gonna go for that. We're gonna get the 4 curtains. I think they actually require some of those stuff here. Let's check the curtains. Pretty curtains. So I guess it's them. So they are worth 1 clove and 1 wood, so, and 1 clove, that's 3 threads, so we're gonna go for that. And in the future this trading is gonna be way more interesting than it is for the moment. You will actually have gold, so you will trading with, it was some new coming to your town that actually offers things, I think it was shop. And you can choose to buy things, you can even sell things, and you can even see the gold here. And the developers even talked about that, it's not gonna be like it is for the moment. Like we're gonna get these like instant things that come on the ground. So at least their goal is to actually make so it will come a caravan with your stuff and it will come here and sell, and that's pretty awesome. And one thing with this fence here that I'm building that is pretty unsure how it's gonna go with it is that I did try it out on live stream, so I did build an fence, but what happened then? The goblins started coming from the other side, and it's not sure that that will happen with this since it's basically just this way that it can come from. The only problem would be that this staircase we built in an episode before, they might take that way, or they might actually start to spawn inside. So I don't know if it's like with Minecraft where the enemies actually need to have darkness to spawn, or if they can spawn even when it's light, so. And it seems like something is going on here. Maybe, okay. It seems like we're low on wood resources. We have a lot of wood here, but I guess people might be busy with things. Okay, so it's something going on here as well. So I experienced this on when I was playing before as well. So what I think we're gonna do is to actually move these carpenter's workbench. I had a problem with this before as well when I did play before outside of this. So I had to move this because it seemed like these some fences and things got stuck on the carpenter's workbench and they didn't move anything at all, so they just kept putting it everywhere. So those didn't go into the stockpile and it became a big problem, so that's why we didn't have any fences. And it seems like a problem with that, if it happens as well, is that if you choose to maintain a specific craft and it does not go into your stockpile, for me, what I experienced, what I felt with it, is that if it's not in the stockpile, the carpenter, like, it can't see that those exist. So they will keep making them. And how many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we have a lot of them. And I wonder if we can even see some of them. No. You see, we cannot even see those fences here either. So that's a problem that I did have before as well. So it seems like maybe it's just the fences that are bugging out in this way. I don't know why they're doing it, but they are doing it. And this is a bed we should probably move sometime soon. We do not really have any space for that, so what we're gonna need to do is to actually make a new house where we can have that guy girl living, whoever it's gonna be. And where should we have this house? I'm thinking about having it here. It's gonna be a pretty small basic house. I'm gonna make more advanced houses in the future, but like I said previously, I think that the highest priority is just to make sure that your current people are safe, that they have enough food, that they have shelter, that they have some good place to live in. That's like the highest priority for me. Because we gotta keep in mind that we're getting invaded by goblins at the same time, so if you're gonna play this game and you're maybe not, like you haven't played the game a lot, like you probably should go and play not on the fastest speed. I felt that as well, since when I started out I was a totally noob at this and I didn't know much. I'm pretty much a noob at some points of this game still, but I'm trying to learn as I play. And I know one thing, that sometimes you want to speed up the game when you're building something, but sometimes it might actually create a lot of problems when you're doing it, because if you're playing with those goblins on survival mode, you might get invaded and you might not have time to do everything. So I would recommend going for slow speed, at least when you're doing something specific like designing a house or a building. Oh, that actually looks... I like that look. I like that. I like how that looks. Maybe we can see if what will look the best. No, I think we're gonna go for that. I think that looks pretty good. And if you want, we can actually build on top of this roof like you guys had said before in the comments. So with these roofs, if they are flat, you can actually add a floor to it and you can keep building things. But keep in mind, this is very experimental and I have personally experienced a lot of crashes, a lot of bugs with it. Okay, so the trade will be back in 14 hours and it wants those 5 doors. And I don't think it's going to be a problem, since I think we have pretty many doors. Yeah, we have 8 doors and we just gonna need one. So that means we have 7 doors left. So we can have all the doors and... we will get away some doors so we can store other things as well. And we're gonna move those, some of these fences as well. And one thing I'm gonna do in the future as well, it's not really gonna be something that is like having a good function. It might have a little bit of function for it, but the main thing with it is that I'm gonna add fences around farms. And the reason I'm gonna do it is mainly to make it look a little bit better. Make it look a bit, little bit nicer. I did it on another game that I did play, and I think it looks real nice to have some fences around them. I mean, it could protect them a little bit as well. But I noticed it as well, I don't know if it's always like that, I built an gate for the fence and it didn't work. So no one could actually use the fence. So that made a big problem. And we're getting further with this. So they're at least moving these fences, so we'll get into a different place, and hopefully they're actually gonna start to put them where they should be. Okay, we got an error here. Yeah, it's something. So that's something more for like the game developers that make in the game, and I made sure that clicking in that I send information to them that if something goes wrong, they get some information like what is going on inside the game. And if you're gonna play the game, I would leave it on. It's not like it's gonna like leave any personal information about you. It's just gonna make it easier for the developers to find and track some errors. And I'm gonna remove these stone as well, because they are pretty much in the way for our fence. And we still have a lot to build with this. And this is actually a bit risky. If anyone is gonna go and go to that fence when the goblins are coming, people might spill up, so that's not good, and I don't think I can actually cancel what he's doing. So I'm gonna try to... Why? Alert is not working. Hey, what's going on here? So we're gonna try to load the game, since for some reason the alert thing do not work. So we're gonna just load the game, and that solves really... So hopefully it's gonna work now. Yeah. And you see our people are split up, so this is a bit of a problem. And this is something that I do not really like about this game, that when I'm getting split up like this, I don't like that at all. Like, I want to command my people in some way, at least with footmans. I think that would be a really good thing. So hopefully, yeah, we did beat this guy, so that's good. But the media adding many features, they're improving many things over time, and they have a bunch of new things that's gonna come in new updates, so that is really, really good. I'm looking forward to see those. Oh my god, there's coming more goblins. So we did get the double invasion this time. I wonder if it is because I did a load there and that made it go even worse. I don't know. I haven't gotten two invasion with this many people at the same time before, at least. So we really need to get this fence down because... Oh! He teleported up to the roof. So I think we're gonna let him stay there. I mean, if you can't do anything up there, we're just gonna let him stay there and have some fun if you think that is fun. Hey, get him! No one is getting him, he's just right by us. Is it one inside his house? I removed the alert and everybody started fleeing. I think we actually have to kill this guy because it seems like he's scaring them. Oh, we're so scared. He's standing on the roof and everybody's sleeping in a circle around him. Oh my god. Okay, so let's build a stair up to him. Everybody's sleeping, so I guess people are busy for the moment. They are taking a nice little nap. But at least no one died, so... I really want to make sure that our people is gonna stay safe, and I don't want any more people to die. I wonder if they're actually gonna build this, or if they're gonna be too scared to do it. Okay, so they just woke up and fall back to sleep. Hey, get up! What is this? Devoted? What? So what does that mean? Do they have like a girlfriend, or what? What does this thing mean, guys? Devoted. This is a heart, so I would guess that they are like in love with someone, or like together with someone, have a relationship with someone. They need to wake up and kill that goblin. It's even coming a goblin right now. Yeah, they got up now. Let's alert them. Kill him. Awesome. Okay, it seems like... Nope. It was just fooling me. The ladder was there and then it was gone. Oh, that goblin. He was a pretty nice guy. Actually came back with our basket of food. That was nice of him. Trader will be back in 4 hours. Yeah, now they're gonna go and build that ladder, so hopefully we'll be able to defeat him. Maybe we're gonna get him to come down to us. Yeah. Kill him. He built a ladder and he got scared. I think everybody should have known that he was up there, so... And do we see any fences inside here? Nope. No fences. I know that there were something with defenses that did changes, so it might be that the Humble Bundle version of the game Alpha 5, even though it's Alpha 5, it might be that this version is older than the Steam version, so I'm gonna see if I'm gonna go back to starting the Steam version, just to see if they are different. And we should put a lamp here somewhere, we should have it there, it should be pretty good, and remove that ladder. And we're gonna remove this ladder as well, so we're not gonna keep any ladders that we made for getting down resources or for getting down those goblins, so really need to get this wood. Is he lying there waiting for us? Oh, a worker would like to join, awesome. And that is one thing that changed the game that I think is one of the best features coming to the game. So basically how I understand it is the way you're gonna go, you can go into someone and that has a work. You see this says show workshop, but in the new one you actually need to be able to switch the work they're gonna do, so they will go and leave their current tool and will also go and get a new tool for the new work, so you can apply them for a new work. And if you have too many carpenters like crafters and such, you can actually change them into normal work, and that is awesome that they added that. So we want to trade that, of course, and we got some curtains. 4 curtains for 5 doors, so that just cost us 5 wood. What's going on here? Is it a goblin? Why is he scared? He's scared of the curtains, maybe. Why is he scared of the curtains? That's not good. But guys, this is gonna be it for today with Stoneheart, and I hope you enjoyed this episode, and in the future one we're gonna continue building this town and we're gonna continue expanding, and we're definitely gonna get this fence down soon, and so on. So guys, if you like this, feel free to leave a thumbs up, and if you'd like to see more with me Banto playing Stoneheart and other games, subscribe to my channel, and see you guys next time, and have a great day. Take care.